Hello dear children, this is me Hemant Kumar Devre. Today we are going to revise lesson number 4 from geography, and that is maps. Okay, this is also a part of your syllabus for periodic test 2. So today we are going to revise this lesson. First of all, we'll move with the multiple choice questions, that is very short type of questions. Okay, so question number 1, what is a globe? What is a map? So question is given here, what is a map? Okay, options are given here, A, B, C, D. So correct option from the above options is a drawing of the earth's surface on a flat paper according to scale. Second question, what is a physical map? So from the given options, we have to choose the correct one. A map which shows natural features on the earth, it is called as physical map. Next question number 3. The question is, which map gives us more information from the below mentioned? So the large scale map is such a map which gives us the more information. Next, we find arrow, okay, arrow pointing towards the, and that arrow shows that, what does that arrow show? That arrow shows the north direction. Okay, any of the curtain, it is also given open from this side, so that shows the north direction. On the map also there is an arrow and shows the north direction. Question number 5, the blue color is used for showing. On map we use blue color and that is used for showing water. Next question number 6, a scale is compulsory for? Scale is compulsory for a map. Next number 7, for what purpose magnetic compass is used? I have taught you lesson when I have explained this completely, I have told you, okay, very finely, minutely I have showed while explaining the lesson. So kindly try to remember the things. Okay, so here we will see for what purpose magnetic compass is used. So that is for finding the directions, because magnet sustains in a north and north direction, that's all. Let us move towards some very short type of questions. One line answer question in short. First question is define scale. So scale is a ratio between actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. Second question, define conventional symbols. Conventional symbols are internationally accepted common signs and symbols used on the maps. We will see later what are the conventional symbols are. Okay. Next, we have to define intermediate directions. The direction on the compass between halfway cardinal points are intermediate directions. Okay. Now, these are some extra questions. From this chapter, you have to find out the answers of these questions by looking into the book, textbook. Okay. What are the advantages of a globe? What is a map? What are the main purposes? What are the main purpose of a map? What is an atlas? What are physical and of relief maps? Next, what are political maps? What are thematic maps? How many components does a map have? Okay, what is a scale? How is it is used? Why scale is very important in a map? Find the answers of these questions by looking into your book. Next, moving towards the different questions, 3 marks questions. Okay, the short type of answers. Okay, next, what are the limitations of a globe? Yeah, there are certain limitations with globe that while using. So the globe is little help. Actually, when we want to study a part of the earth about our country, okay, and it says districts, towns and villages. So globe is not easy to handle also. First of all, we have to understand globe is a little help when we have to study only some part of the earth, like about our country, states, districts, cities and towns. That time globe is not that much helpful for all of us. Okay, so globe is also not easy to carry anywhere. It is not easy to handle. Next question, what is a map? Describe its major features. So we have already understood the definition of a map. Map is a representation of the earth's surface or a part of it drawn on flat surface. So one map contains many facts such as a big book. All the maps, when you put together, it makes an atlas. Of maps of various sizes are drawn on different scales in that book. So they provide more information than a globe. Next, what do you mean by a sketch? Define sketch. A sketch is a drawing of an area mainly based on memory, not on the scale. Sometimes what happens, we have to draw a rough drawing of an area. It needed to know where a particular place is located with reference to the other places. With the help of a rough sketch, we may find out the location of a place. Then such a rough drawing drawn without scale, that is called as sketch. Next, what is a plan? What is a plan? A plan is a drawing of small area on large scale. Then a large scale map depicts much information. Sometimes we want to know the length and the breadth of a room, which cannot be shown on a map. In such an event, we can refer drawings drawn on scale. So it is known as a plan. We will see later. Describe various types of maps. And the various types of maps are as follows. Physical map, which shows the natural features on the earth like mountain, plain, plateaus, rivers and all. Then that is, for example, physical map of the world, physical map of India. Political map, political maps actually where a different, this shows a different countries and states of the world with their boundaries. Political boundaries, we can say. Then thematic map, actually these maps are very specific type of map with they contain specific information of they are called as thematic map. For example, road maps of India, rainfall maps, distribution of the, and this is called forest distribution. They have certain themes, that's why they are called the thematic maps. Next is give historical background of maps. What is a historical background? This is very application type of questions according to your knowledge. So what you have learned from this lesson? So there is a, everything has a history of it. So we have to understand this. So what is the history of this? So the science of making is termed as cartography. Science of making map is cartography. Then ancient maps makers did not know the scale of the earth, first of all. Then Babylonians drew maps assuming that the earth is flat, as a flat one. So it drawn in that way. An Egyptian geographer, that is cartographer, he Ptolemy first represented earth as a sphere. Then he drawn the map according to the sphere shape. So maps were drawn on a different marks and the different materials also they have done. Then Eskimos used the animal skin. Egyptian also used metal plates, as well as the Babylonians made maps of the tablets. So clay tablets, we have to understand this. In this way, these questions are there, long questions. What are the components of maps, distance, direction and symbol? You have to explain in detail. Then next is name the two types of maps based on a scale. So there are two types of, small scale and large scale. Small scale map is actually when large areas are shown on small maps, that is called small scale map. These maps give very limited information and the map of India is a small scale map. Then large scale maps, if you talk about, so when small areas shown on large map, that is called the large scale maps. These maps give us detailed information. And the map of Delhi, the map of Shirpur also can be talked, means of your local areas also, locality also can be. So how is the distance measured? Define a scale. So there we have to understand, map reduce the entire world or its part on its fit on a sheet of paper. Means I can draw from Shirpur to Dhule. So in this way, this completely done. But this reduction is done very carefully, so that distances between the places are kept true. So Dhule and Shirpur is actually, we know that 55-60 kilometers. So we have to show on a scale. For example, 1 centimeter is equal to 6 kilometers. So 10 centimeter will be equal to 60 kilometers. So reduction of map is only possible when small distances on a paper represents a large distance on a ground. So to reduce map, scale is chosen. Scale is chosen, actually the ratio between actual distance on the ground and the distance shown on the map. So distance between school and home of a student, for example, is 10 kilometers. So if he shows 10 kilometers distance by 2 centimeter on a map, it means 1 centimeter is equal to 5 kilometers. The scale is chosen. Next, scales are used for measuring distance. For example, to find out the distance between the post office and the clock tower. For example, of your home also can be taken. One can measure distance between these two points on a map, for here to here, and then the same distance on the scale, the types of maps based on the scale. What are symbols? Why do we need them? Actually, symbols are very important on a map, and we have internationally confirmed some symbols, and we use those symbols. Okay, so those symbols are actually why do we have to consider? Okay, with different size features like buildings, roads, trees, railway lines, the merge, different things like hospitals, well, everything on a map, and we use various symbols to show them. So symbols gives us much information on a limited space. With the help of these symbols, we can draw maps as we need, as we read them easily. Okay, without knowing any of the languages, we can directly identify it easily. It is identify too. Okay, that we collect some information on maps with the help of these symbols without knowing language also. So maps have a universal language, a language that cannot be read by all. Okay, and international agreement facilities of these use of symbols allow us to do so. So symbols are called the conventional symbols, and some of the symbols, conventional symbols are shown in the figure that we will see. Okay, so these are the some conventional and non-conventional symbols: metal road, car track, and all other things and all. Okay, so broad gauge, steam tank, trees, settlements, post office, roads, railways, different types of these things are shown. Roads, boundaries, rivers. See, you can see the symbols here. Village, open village, walled village, uninhabited, all these things are clearly explained. So in this way, I have explained you the revised lesson in short. Okay, so you have to study properly, read your textbook thoroughly, and try to read lesson line to line. Okay, so I hope this is enough for the revision, but you need to read your lesson carefully. Thank you so much. Watch it carefully. Keep your textbook with you while watching the video.